Like and subscribe right now, or you're going to have bad luck for the rest of the week.
Sports is a way that brings people together in the most incredible of ways. We all stay with our eyes glued to the screens in anticipation for what's next because we never know what can happen in a split second. These are the moments we all savor, and every so often we get a chance to witness history unfold in front of our eyes. Some of these moments become great and are remembered for years simply due to their near impossible nature. So sit back and watch 10 times that impossible became possible in sports. Watch out for number one, as it is completely unbelievable. But before we get into all that, don't forget to like and subscribe to our channel. Number 10, Bethany Hamilton. Bethany Hamilton is a surfer who started surfing at a very young age. She excelled on the waves with her incredible surfing skills and professional stunts long before she was unfortunate to be attacked by a tiger shark at 13 years of age, back in 2003. The attack cost Hamilton her arm, but her undying passion and courage remained whole. She couldn't live long without her passion and entered the waters again just 1 month after the attack with a custom board and, after changing her style to surf with one arm, entered and won professional competitions. Just 1 year after the accident in 2004, Hamilton won the NSSA National Competition in Australia, winning it again the next year in the USA, and has continued winning competitions ever since. Number 9. Eric Weinenmeier trumps Everest. You might be wondering, what's so impossible about this? It's not like it hasn't been done before. More than 3,000 people have seen the roof of the world, so why is this any kind of impossible accomplishment? Well, this guy Eric was born with a retinal condition called retinoscosis, which resulted in him being blind by the age of 13. You heard that right. He went all the way across the treacherous Kembu Icefall, up the Lost Face, across hidden crevices on the western CWM, up the Avalanche-prone North Col, along the precipitous Northeast Ridge, with no sight. Just try walking a block or two in your neighborhood with your eyes closed, even with a friend to guide you, and then think about your chances of getting up a man-killing mountain without your sight. And then you will come to know why exactly that this is a miraculous achievement. Number 8. Jumping to your death. Skydiving is a popular sport performed by adrenaline junkies and highly adventurous people, and it is terrifying to the core. There is a variant of skydiving that will not only scare these adrenaline junkies, but could potentially result in death. This intense sport is known as bonsai skydiving. In this form, they first throw the parachute and then jump after it. The aim is to catch the parachute in just enough time so that the diver can make sure the harness is secured, pull the ripcord, and land safely to the pre-planned spot. Everything must be synchronized and timed exactly to ensure not even the tiniest thing goes wrong in the whole process. Otherwise, it could result in the death of the diver. Now this daring skydiver, Yoshiro Kubo, has won a place in the Guinness Book of World Records by waiting 50 seconds after jumping before regaining and deploying his parachute. With exceptional skills and an undaunting attitude, he was able to retrieve the parachute and was able to glide down and land at the pre-planned spot. Wondering what's so jaw-dropping about this? 50 seconds is almost the length of 2 TV commercials, and when you're hanging up in the air without a parachute, it can feel like forever. Number 7. George Foreman beats Michael Moore. It was back in 1994 when the impossible dream of George Foreman was fulfilled, when he, former heavyweight champion, became the oldest man to win the heavyweight crown at the age of 45, in the 7th year of the most unlikely comeback run. The fight itself has become part of boxing folklore and is remembered because of the contrast between Foreman and Michael Moore, two men from different generations with completely different backgrounds and personalities. So why was it deemed impossible? Foreman was much older, much slower, and a lot less flexible than the spry in his prime Moore. Statistically, rationally, logically, and biologically, there was no way Foreman should have won that fight against a 27-year-old reigning champion. But it was a matter of just one perfectly placed punch that shattered the huge wall of impossibility. The younger Moore, who was a 3-to-1 betting favorite over the much older Foreman, was boxing his way through the entire fight. It wasn't until the 10th round when Foreman landed a hefty punch right that sent Moore down for the count, and he couldn't beat the 10 count. The right Foreman landed, he said, was the key to his victory, and his knockdown is one of the most iconic ones in his career because of it. Number 6. Jim Abbott. The man's entire career is the very definition of making the impossible possible. Jim is nowadays considered as one of the best pitchers in the history of baseball, but his career becomes more impressive and beyond belief when we get to know that he was born without his right hand. He was known to be an amazing quarterback in high school, and despite huge chances of a much easier and promising career in American football, he chose to be a baseball player and did not let his deformity come into the ways of his passion. Even though most people around him tried to convince him that it was almost impossible for a kid with such disability to be a pitcher in the game that requires playing with your hand, Jim didn't give up. With persistence, he was shortlisted and picked to play in the Olympics, where he won an unofficial gold medal for the U.S. since baseball was used as a demonstration sport. Later, he went on to play for the California Angels, the New York Yankees, and the Chicago White Sox, and displayed his unmatched talents there. Number 5. Monet Davis. It was in 2014 when a young 13-year-old girl broke all the stereotypes that boys were better in sports than girls. Although Monet Davis wasn't the first girl to participate in the Little League World Tournament, she was the first African-American to play baseball in it, and we can undoubtedly say that she was one of the greatest players, as her electrifying shots were worth witnessing during the whole tournament. Even though her team didn't win in the end, Monet was the star of the tournament. Leading her team as the pitcher, she brought her team to the Little League World Series with a remarkable win during the qualifying round and opened the tournament with an incredible score of 8 strikeouts, 0 walk completes shutout against Tennessee. She then followed up with an RBI double the following game against Texas. Of course, it was her previously mentioned historic performance against the team from Nashville which turned her from a notably good pitcher to a national sports sensation overnight, increasing her fan following among the sports geeks and tons of people around the country, and the buzz around the Little League World Series was greater than ever before just because of her. Although her team didn't win the tournament in the summer of 2014, Monet Davis became a well-known baseball champion of America because of her outstanding performance and creating the most unforgettable sports moments of the decade. Number 4. Michael Jordan's last shot. This list would stay incomplete if we do not mention the greatest basketball player of all time. It wasn't thought that Michael Jordan's last shot as a member of the Chicago Bulls would have such an immense effect on the history of the game. In Game 6 of the NBA Finals in 1998, Jordan and the other team members of the Chicago Bulls were on the road to Utah trying to finish their second three-peat of the game. With less than 19 seconds remaining in the game, Jordan caught everybody's attention when he stole the ball from Karl Malone, and following the possession, magic happened. Jordan drove right past Brian Russell and crossed over back to the left, where he drained up and gained the game-winning two-point jump shot with just 5.2 seconds left on the clock. It was a brilliant moment that topped off the era of the 1990s Bulls dynasty. Number 3. The Miracle on Ice. Amidst the political tensions of the Cold War, the US and USSR hockey teams faced off during the 1980 Winter Olympics. The USSR team was considered very formidable for bringing the gold championship home after winning 5 of the last 6 gold medals. But that did not actually happen, as you will see in a few moments. The inexperienced and naive US national team trailed 3-2 heading into the third period. And the miracle happened when they scored twice in the final frame to take down the Soviets with this score of 4-3. Isn't that incredible? Number 2. The Swedish Tiger. Zlatan has long since maintained a mysterious status in the minds of the European football fan, a supremely arrogant man who frequently refers to himself as the world's best player. Ibrahimovic has for many years done very little to justify his grand proclamation. But he does have his fair share of wonder goals that no one can take from him. And his best one? Everyone knows what we're talking about. On November 14th in 2012, England played Sweden in a friendly to open a new stadium. England looked like the true winner, but Zlatan had different plans. In the game, Zlatan scored a hat trick before the injury time. But that wasn't the best thing about that night. The ex-Sweden football team captain scored with a bicycle kick from 30 yards out over England's goalkeeper, Joe Hart. Ibrahimovic, who went on to win the FIFA Goal of the Year award for this goal in 2013, applied the overhead kick in the injury time after Hart cleared the ball in play with a header. This goal is considered by many the best of the last decade. What do you think? Number 1. Wilt Chamberlain's 100-point game. Among all the accolades that Wilt Chamberlain garners throughout his career, this one is probably the most popular. Wilt was known for scoring multiple points, dominating the court, apparently every time he stepped in it. He surpassed all expectations and broke all the records of his scores on the 2nd of March 1962 when he scored 100 points in a single game. Yes, you heard that right, 100 points. This is something that is hard to believe to date, and it seems impossible to reach the record that he has set. Many have tried to get close to the record but have failed, and a lot of people believe that his record will never be broken. Well, that concludes our list of top 10 times when nearly impossible feats were performed in sports. Which one did you find the most mesmerizing and incredible? Tell us in the comments section below. Smash that like button and subscribe to our channel.